Can the Lakers get Anthony Davis going here? Clearly need him to have a monster night if they're going to have even a chance.
Ball movement, man movement, wide open shot for Portis.
Reaves on the attack, and a much-needed basket for the Lakers.
I mean, you're shooting over a seven-footer.
Davis, cash money.
This is encouraging.
Shadowed by Connaughton. Shot clock at five. Reaves looking for some daylight. Inside, what a pass. Davis, oh. Vicious stick back.
Oh.
So a 14-point Milwaukee lead as we play with eight and change left in this opening quarter. D'Angelo Russell stops on a dime and makes it look easy.
There was nothing that Reaves can do.
So Giannis already flirting with a triple-double. 11-10 and 4. Hachimura extends, and it is stuck back by Davis. Part of his game, but Anthony Davis, boy, you knew he'd have to have a monster night with LeBron on the shelf.
15 points.
Austin Reaves, little double clutch, gets a soft little bounce in tight. Reaves, Davis, the fake, the fire, way too much. And then Reaves on a snatch. But they finally get it with a corner pocket three from Russell.
And Austin Reaves again with the offensive rebound.
Lakers hitting the offensive glass in the quarter, and it's Russell again. He bangs in a three.
But did you see he banged it in? If you're used to playing it all the time, there's too many shooters on the floor here for Milwaukee.
Errant pass, Reaves. Dinwiddie gets it back, and then Davis to clean things up for the Lakers.
Whoa, we haven't seen enough of it. They started to do it more in the second half after the All-Star break. Here he's getting hot. D'Angelo Russell again dropped 44 on the Bucks March 8th. 13 points here in the third for D'Angelo Russell. Shoulders right into the chest of Anthony Davis to negate that length.
Reggie, amazing to see him still playing at a high level at the age of 35. That is Reaves on a three-point jack.
Leave me out there, coach. I'm not going to raise and tap out.
Hachimura, smart pass to AD. Pretty little extending floater from Davis with 14 off the bench. Little pick and roll action here. Anthony Davis.
Straight giving it to him.
Boy, Reaves. Lakers desperately needed that shot.
So you're starting to see signs.
Yeah,
right?
What better way to get your starting unit back if you're Doc Rivers with, what, a little less than 3 weeks left in the regular season? So now you can start to...
As the Bucks begin the night, 2.5 games in front of Cleveland for the number two slot in the East. Davis is their weak side for the Lakers. Here's Russell. That's a three! And the Lakers, once again, he's played with such a high level of efficiency as Davis, the leader.
Down to 10. Spiro down to 10. 25 and 13 for Giannis right now.
Another night at the office for the two-time MVP. That is Davis from deep. The Lakers have never led tonight. They've been down by as many as 19, and they keep on coming. Reaves to the cup.
Anthony Davis still hobbling a little bit to me. D'Angelo Russell.
Boy, Reaves accelerates, goes right for the teeth of the defense. Team 2 Lakers run. And it's Austin Reaves right in the center of the mix. Anthony Davis with his 20th rebound of the night. Here he is at the other end, and
look,
he buries a three.
Look at this.
And the door is still open for the Lakers.
I'd call a timeout right here. You need to regroup. You need a bucket right here.
Reaves, oh! Deep show.
And the team can get out in transition. They'll burn you from three. 11 of 38 for the Bucks.
Here comes Reaves on the acceleration, and that is a thing of beauty. As we are inside of 3 minutes, Davis. And
got
that
it.
Hits every corner of the rim. Dinwiddie, the kick. Reaves, baseline, and we're tied.
I know this has been all guard dominated here down the stretch, but let AD get a touch here.
Reaves, deep shot for the Lakers. as we get a foul with 30.5 left.
Miscommunication between Damian Lillard and Malik Beasley. Should have been a switch.
Doncic inside, laying it in. Doncic on the scoreboard.
Something that he didn't do as much last year. He was reluctant to shoot that mid-range, doing a much
better job.
Wow.
To Gafford.
I was going to make this point earlier.
Sabonis will go to the free throw line. He was fouled by Irving.
You see that? Just a beautiful decision there by Luka. And that
11-7 Sacramento. Doncic on the drive, got some space to pull up, rattles it home. Irving inside, left hand, the finger roll is good.
And it was about the attack though by Exum.
He said he never expected the season to go like this. He wanted to perform at the level he knew he could, but to do it consistently like this is different. Mike Brown also told us.
But his IQ and feel for how to play the game really separate him at that position.
Behind the back pass, Washington, the payoff from deep.
From Luka, he is so good in that pick and roll and just throws it behind the back right in rhythm where the defender couldn't rotate up from the baseline and contest. So terrific job with the spacing. You see Fox just account late.
After getting wins last night, the Mavericks in Utah, the Kings at home against Philly. A crossover, step back, Irving, lightning.
That three-point shot that Sacramento creates that allowed him to get to the rim.
Doncic for three. He's in double figures with 10. Double overtime. Lakers coming back from 19 down to win 128-124. We have a good one early here at Golden 1 Center. Doncic for three. Filthy.
And even though he misses that, he's got to take that shot. That's you can't allow the miss to stop him from shooting it. How about that play by Gafford?
Hot potato. And Sabonis clears. Monk lost the handle, and it's Doncic the other way, and the easy lay-in. Doncic at 29 last night. A little step back. Murray is pure.
See, Luka, just see how patient he is. That speaks to what Coach Dunley was talking about, keeping him out of transition.
Irving splashing the triple. Irving getting by the defense and throwing it down now.
Kai. You know, you hear the players around the league oftentimes talk about who's the most skilled guy. He doesn't play defense. He was terrific on that possession against Sabonis on the post.
Irving gives it up. Doncic pull up over Fox's pure. DJ Washington has not missed a three tonight. Fox couldn't hit. It is a 13-2 Dallas run. Irving English off the window. Washington the rebound.
It is one and done.
Lively the throwdown.
And we talked about how about the hands on that catch there. Take a look. How about the catch?
That is called.
Yeah, that's extremely difficult to do.
In game one of our doubleheader against Milwaukee. Turnover. Doncic bounce pass. Right away, getting up.
And they just had a hard time trying to get anything at the rim.
Step back. Irving. Good. Irving has to give it up. Got it back. Shot clock winding down. Three ball. Pure. A shooting clinic.
Kyrie in a great rhythm right now offensively.
In this building back in January. First possession, there is Chet Holmgren launching. And an offensive rebound. Giddey, quick put back, and he floats it up and in. Nicely done. Josh Giddey, who's been getting off the quick start.
That's what he does.
Dort almost stepped on that sideline, just did keep the heel above the tape. There is a three-point shot from the outside. And again, as Holmgren Out on the perimeter. Up top, it's Giddey. Thinking about it. Launches again, and that's two here for Josh Giddey in the first quarter.
He has such a big body when he gets close to the basket. But he's vulnerable away from it.
Oh, nice drive. There is J-Dub putting it on the deck. One dribble and a great job. Good defense by J-Dub. Now he's racing down the floor once again. He's going to play through it, and the foul.
We talked about you got to put your work in early against Zion.
The Pelicans get back defensively. J-Dub from the outside reins in that three.
He set Zion up for that one because...
Good intensity here in the first 5 minutes. Giddey shows the touch with that floater right over Valanciunas.
Man, he is just sprouting.
And the Pelicans, four threes here in this first quarter. SGA back in the game. Spinning right around Alvarado. Nice move. And SGA has his first made basket of the game.
In the air that time.
So Shea, that different rotation here, starts the second quarter, and he shoots it right over Marshall. He's got 4 points. Check that make it cool with him. Going into the chest of Chet Holmgren. SGA, that time on the other side of the floor from the baseline. He's got another two.
Oh, he's starting to be test him anyway.
SGA, one-on-one with Murphy. Spins, hangs, floats, and scores. Nicely done. And Willie Green of the Pelicans forced to call a timeout.
And you know what year the merger happened? I'm going to give you a pop quiz.
76-77.
Oh, come on, man. You looked at something.
I didn't cheat. Oh, what a shot there from J-Dub.
Converting turnovers, too, as well.
J-Dub has it on the run. Fears left. Bounces off of McCollum. Shot in the way, and he beats the buzzer. And the possession results in a deuce. I think if Chet Holmgren waited just a smidge longer, it would have just been a clean block. J-Dub in the corner. High arcing three. There's another one for him as he cans it from deep. As SGA with Marshall on him. Dancing, spinning, hanging, and the shot goes with 1 second on the clock.
Those dynamic players like that.
You hear Mark Daigneault about those dynamic players, Michael, and one of the keys is to just create a crowd. Use different defenders. There's a turnover by the Pelicans. SGA on the move. Gives it up. Giddey, quick release, and he banks it home.
How about that quick pass?
Dort keeps it on the perimeter. Giddey's going to have to make a move. Tied up the shot and just in front of the end of the shot clock. Sure. Murphy the move. Murphy flies up and got denied at the top. An incredible two-handed block from Holmgren. On the other end, it's Giddey spinning into the transition bucket.
What do we talk about first?
And it was Chet Holmgren with the two-handed block instead. That was incredible defense. J-Dub, skip pass. There's Giddey, lines it up from the outside, and Josh Giddey continuing to feel it. Giddey with 19 in the game. He's the Thunder's leading scorer. SGA spinning, floating on Marshall, and Marshall just has not been able to stop him when SGA wants to get into his move. Shea drives left. Oh, and then he goes with the lollipop layup, the left hand.
Absolutely. He tries it.
Pelicans keep applying the pressure. SGA inside. He goes with the left hand and scores. And the Thunder get a much-needed bucket. Got the bucket on the last possession. Now the ball in the hands of J-Dub. Wants to drive on his former teammate. Floats in the air. That time he finished right going left. Little jab step. What does he decide to do? Tough step back shot. That rims up. Nice rebound by SGA. The floater, the lob, and Chet Holmgren on the alley-oop puts it down.
It's an ice water in your vein. Contorting finishes. And he's got a lob, man, and Chet, and it's as advertised.
You were right on point. It was almost as though you knew exactly what was coming based off the SGA. With Zion defending. Ball out to the perimeter. It's Holmgren. Giddey outside, and that three silences the crowd. Michael, how can the Thunder find that groove that they had in the first half?
Well, just knock it down shots. I mean, that's what they did. You know, that's Josh Giddey. You know, it's going to come down this game.
Over the head pass to Giddey. Giddey behind the back door, wide open for three in the corner. SGA taps it over to J-Dub in the right place at the right time. Thunder with another opportunity to get a little closer here, trailing one possession game. Shea bounces. Wants to reset the offense. Holmgren again on the dive, but instead it's SGA stepping back and nailing it. Massive possession. J-Dub looking for a couple of screens. Got around Holmgren. Drives in and scores.
I tell you, he is such a dynamic player.
He's another. Warriors needed to contest threes better than they did the other night.
Well, he's another one of their shooters.
Steph cutting back door. Setting up Klay. Pump fake still work. Klay Thompson laying it in. Ozier stayed with him. Shot clock at 9. Klay can shoot over Patty Mills. He drops it off to Wiggins. And spoon feeds Andrew for the lay-in.
So that's what happens against a really good defensive team sometimes.
Marquez knocked it away. Klay from the elbow. Rimming that home.
Even though it wasn't a pass, Clay's always ready. Sprung into action.
Adebayo getting deep position. And there's Draymond again. Good outlet from Steph. Klay Thompson laying it up and in.
Oh, did you see the deceleration from Klay Thompson? You see that from Doncic a lot?
For like 3 months.
That makes sense.
Klay Thompson. So Looney, he got the Warriors a free 3 points just by effort on that missed free throw rebound. Spoelstra's going to say, all right, the second unit, how well do they dissect the zone? That's the zone buster right there.
Making every pass tough.
It's 5-on-4. Rozier's behind the play. And Klay, an open three. That's the one you needed.
Did you see Draymond tell Wiggins, get out of there. I got a shooter in the corner.
Get up. So you're trying to find some flow now. Steph, Klay, Wiggins, Kuminga, Draymond. Same five that started. Klay Thompson hasn't cooled off. He's got 18. When you've got a finals-level crew chief, he's like, hey, let's just, we'll call real fouls as Klay lays that in. Perfect give and go with Draymond.
This defender wasn't in between him and the basket.
Jovic attacking. Looney is there. Good pass to Bryant. Klay is there with a block. Klay Thompson.
Defensively. Jovic kind of beat his man off the dribble. Drew
Ozier on the baseline and threw it away. Chris Paul's running with Pajemski. He's got Klay as the trail. Now his feet are set. And now it's in the bucket.
That was money all the way. You can start counting it up.
Defense.
And then working on the offensive side, we know Klay Thompson can do this in transition. That's why you get up and down. Don't go.
Set up Wiggins for three. Kuminga, another opportunity to use clock here if you wanted. Klay from the wing. Nah, not when I've got 25 points. A poor game by the Warriors. It was 21 made threes and excellence by the T-Wolves. It was a 4-point win.
He just had a rough stretch with the turnovers
you
there.
Did. Ending the third, beginning the fourth. Klay Thompson.
Middleton playing his fourth game back since missing the 5+ weeks. Lillard underneath to Antetokounmpo. Collects and gets right to work for the Bucks.
Lopez may have gotten a finger on that shot there by Reaves. We got two of the best shot blockers in the game on the floor tonight. Anthony Davis, and there's the putback by
Lillard into the corner. This is Antetokounmpo against Davis. What a matchup.
Oh, my
there
goodness.
Extends hard two-handed flush.
Spiro, look at this move right here. Get out the way. And he just straight moved Anthony Davis out of the way.
It's one of the premier defenders, and there he is at the other end getting a fingertip on it. You guys all have my stamp of approval.
Are we close to saying it?
Yeah,
okay.
You're very close, Reggie. Beasley open three, splash! And Antetokounmpo with the rebound. Here he comes on the attack. Into the corner. Connaughton. Splash.
6-0 Laker run here. Start this second quarter.
Bobby Portis finds the laces. And he buries it three. As Hachimura misses from the top of the key. Antetokounmpo, little Euro step. Count it. And he's headed to the free throw line.
By Giannis Antetokounmpo. Here's a little drop off by Connington. And there's the contact on the back.
As AD misses a little step back. It took Darvinham a while, but he has gone back to it as Antetokounmpo goes glass, just evading Hachimura.
In case everyone's wondering.
That was my next question. Middleton ahead of the pack. Here's Antetokounmpo. Scary sight. Extends. Nothing you can do in the open floor. He's got 13 for Milwaukee.
The Lakers struggling from distance.
It's been the issue for this team. Antetokounmpo, pretty setup. And just like that, they're leading.
Average 30-plus points and shoot 60-plus percent from the field. That's remarkable.
Beautiful bounce. Lopez underneath. And he keeps on coming.
Yeah, bigger things on our mind right now, and that's trying to secure that number one seed, and they've gone after it.
Antetokounmpo extends, and they're going to count the field goal. So D'Angelo Russell, a slow start tonight, but he's starting to cook.
And the zone here for the Lakers defensively.
Lopez makes him pay for it. Davis thought about the give and go action, poked away. Well done by Antetokounmpo. Here he is running the break. Dazzling pass to Middleton. Whistle charge to Lopez.
There's the defense. The deflection comes up with a steal. Smart move by Lopez to get the ball back to Giannis.
Seven to shoot. Extends short. Beasley. So a 19-point Bucks lead is down to seven. This is Middleton from deep. Got it.
D'Angelo. Now the Lakers back in the zone again.
Two-man action.
Oh! Uh-oh. Watch your head there.
Your high degree of difficulty.
Yes.
Russell! Turn back.
Look at the length here. On full display here by Giannis.
And here comes Reaves on a push. Reaves going to reset to Davis. Swallowed up, gets it back, goes left hand, and he missed again. You're right, he's gassed. Green ahead of the field. This is Crowder. Fires in and out. Offensive rebound. And that's going to get us to the end of quarter number three. Throwing punches. And Milwaukee is going to take a... The Lakers have never led tonight. Antetokounmpo on a pretty pass by Middleton.
I like Darvin Ham starting this overtime with Rui.
Trying to get the Lakers some more size, but he turns it over. Antetokounmpo, three on two. Beasley! The Lakers 14-7 since Hachimura was inserted into the starting lineup in early February. Middleton! Dazzling dime for Antetokounmpo.
Lillard looked like he's on an empty tank.
Antetokounmpo has played 45 minutes, Lillard 48. Giannis extends where he can tie it with 1:17 left in double OT.
Anytime Giannis would have gotten this ball in the paint, I would have wrapped him up or fouled him hard.
Yeah, and he matched up well in the first game, AD, at 15-9 with four dimes. Now, here goes Z, all the way to the hole.
Again, we talked about this in the pregame show.
He was 4-6 in their blowout loss.
Pull through, two dribbles, right to the front of the rim.
Jalen Williams, only guy in the league to average 19-plus, 50-plus from long range, 44-plus. Z got home.
Nice. He uses that size.
He's a big guard.
Yeah, very much so.
Yeah, he's a legit 6'8". It'll be Trey, deep three. Got it! That's huge.
Say it again, Joe.
That is massive.
Yes, it is.
Massive. Keeping it at six after the turnover. It'll be Trey catch and shoot time. Yes!
The thing that you can't do if you're Josh Giddey, you can't help off that dude.
But still a factor. Now Z up against Jalen Williams. He's got a strong side. He'll get there.
Yeah. Because you put Larry in his corner, so...
And especially when you consider you want to take it to the basket occasionally, the charge. It'll be Herb. He got Giddey out of position. He thought there was contact. He'll take the bucket. Yeah, Dagnoff, first year, 22 wins. 24 second season, 40 last year. Jose off the bench, in the bucket. 1 point game.
And be ready to shoot.
Good grab. Jose now with eight on the shot clock. Go back to Z. He will. And
too strong.
Works.
Too strong.
Pels
too
with
strong.
Their first lead of the game. Problems. Really solid beginning, though.
You love this. Repost. And he's too big and too strong for Gordon Hayward. The dang it, Mo.
Dang it. Why did I do that to myself? On the corner three, Hawk. Got it!
Here's the thing.
Boy, that took a long time. But they have been also running doubles at the Pels. Z's going to get there. And curls it home, even with contact. Not getting any stops at all. Z held up by Williams. It'll be CJ. He's due. Got it. 9-point game. kind of look is it going to be? Z, and all the way into Holmgren with contact. Gordon Hayward back in there.
Because you always know Chet Holmgren somewhere around.
It'll be CJ, another. Got it. He's warming up. Pels back within 13.
Just a few minutes, I think it's coming.
It's turned over. Hayward thought he was hit. He's behind the play. You got a 5-on-4, right.
Got the floor out of balance.
Z all the way to the hole. Glides his way home. Pels back within 4, 12 straight. Jose's back out there, and he was good in the first 12 minutes.
Number one has to touch this ball.
And he does, and he goes all the way to the hole.
Number one has to touch this ball.
Up against Trey. Good challenge. Trey got a piece of it. Najee picks it up. Pels only down 2. Z on the run. All the way to the hole. Second team foul. But how about the block?
Defense to offense, Joe. You got the block right here. Then advance it to Zion. Give him an opportunity.